Good morning. Today we will start with chemical reactions. First line analysis of steady flow combustion. Liquid propane C3H8 enters the combustion chamber at 25 degrees Celsius at a rate of 0.05 kg per minute. So this is your liquid propane here. And the excess, 50% of excess air enters the combustion chamber at 7 degrees Celsius. So this is air at 7 degrees Celsius, which is 50% more. An analysis of combustion gases reveal that all the hydrogen in the fuel burns to HO2. So whatever the hydrogen here, it will burn to HOT. And only 90% of carbon burns to CO2. So this 90% of this carbon burn to CO2, with the remaining 10% forming carbon monoxide. So this remaining is carbon monoxide. If the exit temperature of the combustion gas is 1500 Kelvin, determine the mass flow rate of air and the rate of heat transfer from the combustion chamber. So you have to find what is the mass flow rate of air and what is the rate of heat transfer from the combustion chamber. The theoretical amount of air is determined from the stoichiometric reaction. So this is our propane in the liquid form. This is theoretical amount of air or oxygen needed for the burning. The product is carbon dioxide, water, and 3.76 theoretical nitrogen. So this is for the balance equation. Now A theoretical, which is here, is equal to 3 plus 2, because this is oxygen here, 3 molecule, and here 2 molecule of oxygen, which is 5. So the balance equation for actual combustion process with 50% excess air and some carbon monoxide in the products becomes, so now for the balance equation, 5 is the number of moles of oxygen and nitrogen, means theoretical, A theoretical is 5, but for 50% more, instead of 5, we will use 7.5. So here you had propane plus 7.5, this is your air, then 2.7 will be converted into CO2, and as we know, 10% is formed to the monoxide, so it is 0.3 monoxide plus 4 water plus 2.65 oxygen. So this is 2.7, and this is your 0.15 oxygen molecule. So here we have 7.5 oxygen molecule. So we are left with this 2.65 oxygen molecule, because 2 molecules are here. So it is 2.7 and 2.85 plus 2, which is 4.85, and 7.5 minus 4.85 plus 28.2 nitrogen. Now we have to find the air fuel ratio, that is mass of air and mass of fuel, means this is the mass of air and this is the mass of fuel. So mass of air is oxygen here 7.5 and 3.76 nitrogen, and we know the oxygen nitrogen combination is average value is 29 kg per kilomole, and fuel is your 3 carbon atoms, 3 kilomole multiplied by 12 kilogram of per kilomole, and then your 4 is your hydrogen atom, hydrogen molecule. So 4 kilomole into 2, which will come as this much. Now mass of air is equal to air fuel ratio to mass of fuel. So we know that mass of fuel is given 0.05 kilogram fuel per minute. That is the mass flow rate of fuel. If you multiply air fuel ratio, you will get mass of air. So this much amount of air we need to burn 0.05 kg of fuel per minute. The heat transfer from steady flow combustion process is determined from the steady flow energy balance equation, which is E out is equal to E in. As we know, energy out plus the energy of the products is equal to energy of the reactants. So reactant will, energy will be transferred in the form of heat plus whatever products you have. So Q out is equal to reactant energy, sum of all the reactant energy minus sum of all the product energy, where HF is your enthalpy of formation, H is your enthalpy at temperature 280 Kelvin, which is 7 degree of air for the air, because during entering air temperature is 7 degrees Celsius while fuel is 25 and product has 15 Kelvin. So according to these temperature, enthalpy values are given. At 3 temperature, 7 degree means 280 Kelvin, 25 degree means 298 Kelvin and 1500 Kelvin. So what you have to do, take this table and take all values and put in this equation here. So these are your reactants, these are your products. So for say example, we will take example of C3H8, which is at 25 degrees Celsius. So for 3H8 is value is, this one is given, HF, enthalpy of formation is given, other values are not given, so other values are miscellaneous. So for this, so we are using 1 kilomole of C3H8, and this is enthalpy HF plus H at 98 minus H2N98, because fuel is entering at 25 degrees Celsius, so this will cancel out. Second is your example is you can say plus 7.5 kilomole oxygen. So this is your 7.5 oxygen. So oxygen enthalpy of formation is 0, and this is your at 280 and this is at 290. So enthalpy at 290 minus enthalpy at 280, so it will yield. So here it is 0 plus enthalpy at 290, which is your 8150 minus 8682, and so on for the other. And after solving, you will get this much amount of for C3H8. Means this much amount of energy is released kilojoule per kilomole of C3H8 after burning. So thus this much amount of heat is transferred from the combustion chamber for each kilomole of, means if 1 kilomole of this will burn, it means 44 kg of propane, and you when to divide by it by 44, you will get this much amount of kilojoule of energy per kg of the propane. Then the rate of heat transfer for a mass rate of 0.05, because we know mass rate of fuel is this 0.05 kilogram per minute. So when you multiply this, you will get the 6.89 kilowatt of power. So this much amount of heat transfer will be, or you can say this much amount of heat is produced after the combustion per second, because it is kilowatt, so this is per second adiabatic flame temperature. So this is another concept where fuel and air will come. The chamber is fully insulated, so the products will carry the heat. So the temperature in this case of for the products will be the maximum. Let's discuss. In the absence of any work interaction and any changes in kinetic or potential energies, the chemical energy released during a combustion process either is lost as heat to surrounding or is used internally to raise the temperature of the combustion products. The smaller the heat loss, the larger the temperature rise. In the limited case of no heat loss to the surrounding, that is Q is zero, the temperature of the products reach a maximum, which is called adiabatic flame or adiabatic combustion temperature of the reaction. The adiabatic flame temperature of steady flow combustion process is determined by setting Q is 0, W is 0, it yields. So H product is equal to H reactant, because there is no loss to the environment. So whatever the enthalpy of product, the same should be the enthalpy of reactant. So this is your enthalpy of product, this is enthalpy of reactant. Once the reactants and their states are specified, the enthalpy of the reactants can be easily determined. The calculation of the enthalpy of the products is not so straightforward. However, because the temperature of products is not known prior to the calculations, therefore the determination of adiabatic flame temperature requires the use of iterative techniques. Because we know the temperature of the reactant, but we know don't know what is the temperature, maximum temperature which will achieve after the combustion. So temperature is missing. So to balance this equation, we take a say any temperature, we will put according to that temperature, according to the value of temperature, at that what temperature, what is the enthalpy of the, you can say, products, we will put here, then enthalpy of the reactants we will put here, and then we will see whether these equations are equal or not. Whether two values are equal. If they are not equal, we will select another value by approximation when we will put in this here. And whatever the difference, according to the interpretation, or you can say by using the interpolation, we can find what will be the temperature. The calculation of enthalpy of products is not so straightforward. However, because the temperature of products is not known prior to calculation, therefore the determination of adiabatic flame temperature require the use of an iterative technique unless equation for the sensible enthalpy changes of the combustion products are given. A temperature is assumed for the product gases and the H product is determined for this temperature. If it is not equal to H reactant, calculations are repeated with another temperature. The adiabatic flame temperature is then determined from these two results by interpolation. When the oxidant is air, the product gases mostly consist of nitrogen, and a good first guess for the adiabatic flame temperature is obtained by treating the entire product gases as nitrogen. So because you know more in the reactant, the most part is air, which contains the nitrogen, and nitrogen is moles are more. So what we will assume that we treat the whole of the product gases consist of nitrogen. By this we can guess for the adiabatic flame temperature initial, for the first initial value, the entire product gases as nitrogen. So this is the first value which we can obtain by treating the whole products have the only nitrogen. So then you can interpolate according by putting their value, whatever the you can say imbalance in these two equations, whatever the difference for this here product and what is the difference in enthalpy at the reactant. In combustion chamber, the highest temperature to which a material can be exposed is limited by metallurgical consideration. Therefore, adiabatic flame temperature is an important consideration in design of combustion chambers, gas turbines and nozzles. The maximum temperature that occur in these devices are considerably lower than the adiabatic flame temperature. However, since combustion is usually incomplete, some heat loss takes place and some combustion gas is dissipated at high temperature. The maximum temperature in a combustion chamber can be controlled by adjusting the amount of excess air which serves as a coolant. So there is incomplete combustion, but there is a dissipation also. So definitely temperature product is always less than the adiabatic flame temperature, that is T maximum. So adiabatic flame temperature of fuel may have three deciding parameters: the state of reactants, means in which state, whether the liquid, solid or gas, the degree of completion of the reaction, and the amount of air used. For a specified fuel at a specified state, burned with air at a specified state, the adiabatic flame temperature attains its maximum value when complete combustion occurs with the theoretical amount of air.